Now I know that I've done wrong, but I'm gonna keep trying, trying, trying. May have lost so many times before, but I'm gonna keep fighting. Everybody's gonna fall down sometimes, but I can't stay down long. When the light shines down on my face, I'll rise from the ground. Lord knows I prayed my heart would be too strong to break. Oh, so I could just take it. Oh, I'm just gonna wade through the water and let every wave wash the darkness away. I'm gonna keep loving, 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 loving. Anything is possible if I hold on and believe. Feels like it always so heavy on me, and I can't be free. Lord knows I prayed my
itself is not enough, and it is because of our effort toward getting straight to the root that people oftentimes think we are dealing in hate. We are oppressed. We are exploited. We are downtrodden. We are denied not only civil rights, but even human rights. So the only way we're going to get some of this oppression and exploitation away from us or aside from us is come together against a common enemy. Who taught you to hate the texture of your hair? Who taught you to hate the color of your skin to such extent that you bleach to get like the white man? Who taught you to hate the shape of your nose and the shape of your lips? Who taught you to hate yourself from the top of your head to the soles of your feet? Who taught you to hate your own kind? Who taught you to hate the race that you belong to? So much so that you don't want to be around each other. No, before you come asking Mr. Muhammad, does he teach hate? You should ask yourself, who taught you to hate being what God gave you? And I, for one, as a Muslim, believe that the white man is intelligent enough. If he were made to realize how black people really feel and how fed up we are without that old compromising sweet talk. Stop sweet talking it. Tell him how you feel. Tell him how, what kind of hell you've been catching, and let him know that if he's not ready to clean his house up, he shouldn't have a house.